Okay, so today we will study about the working principle of a reciprocating air compressor, and for this I will consider a generic case I will consider so that it will be beneficial for you. And the case I will consider here, it will be a two-stage. Reciprocating air compressor, briefly written as RAC, having clearance volume. In your syllabus, it was there, single stage compressor with clearance and without clearance. So at the beginning, if we will start from two stage RAC, reciprocating air compressor, having clearance volume, so it will be of a very much practical approach, and it will be beneficial for you at the initial stage to know the practical implication of this compressor. So first know the block diagram. Okay, first after getting the block diagram, we can go for the indicator diagram. So here, this is the first stage compressor. And here the mass induction to this. It is mounted over some kind of storage tank. Later I will tell. So this is the induction. This is the suction valve. And if we will measure with the help of a pressure gauge and temperature, the pressure and temperature recorded to be, let it be P1 and T1. And necessarily, this is approximately equal to atmospheric pressure, that is P ambient, and this temperature is approximately equal to ambient temperature, also T ambient, which this much it is inducted in. And here some arrangement of a filter and damper should be there so that clean air will be sucked inside. And here a piston arrangement, it will be there. This will be the piston, and it is moving, let it be downward stroke. Okay, and this is there. This is state 1. So after the suction stroke, it will be completed here, then the compression will begin, and it will deliver the compressed gas, the first stage. This is the first stage. And the high pressure air will be delivered into the second stage compressor. Before delivered to the second stage compressor, there is some kind of intercooler arrangement. It is called as intercooler. There will be some cooling water circulation is there. So cooling water in, cooling water out. Okay, this is called as intercooler, I/C, intercooler. Okay, and this is necessarily a constant pressure heat exchanger. And from this intercooler, it will go inside a second stage compressor. This one is your second stage compressor. Okay, and from second stage compressor, this will be delivered inside the tank. And there will be some case, there are some after cooler arrangements are there. This is also a after cooler. It is some cases it is provided, otherwise not there. And then it will be stored to tank. Then it will be stored inside this tank. This is the foundation of the receiver tank. And here this will be the second stage compressor. And this whole unit, this is called as receiver or this is your storage tank. Okay, this is your storage tank. So here I will give on some states. So this one is your state one. Then after compressing, after suction the compression will begin, and after compressing this will deliver to this our fastest compressor will deliver the compressed air to this intercooler. It is being recorded by state point 2. The thermodynamic properties at state point 2 are this is P2 and T2. Okay, unnecessarily P2 is more than P1 and T2 is also more than T1, because as pressure is directly proportional to temperature, every compression process is associated with rise in temperature. No one can prevent it. Every compression process is associated with rise in temperature. But the adverse effect is that if the temperature will rise, so here the same case, this T2 is much greater than T1. This is common thing. So if the temperature will rise, then work input will comparatively more. So every effort is being made to cool this. So that's why here the fins arrangements are there, some kind of fins, okay, cooling fins. The surface area is being increased, so these fin arrangements are there. This intercooler arrangement is there. The water is circulated inside this and it will carry away this temperature or this heat, as a result of which the temperature will first fall, there will be no pressure drop. So after intercooler, the thermodynamic state, I can represent it as state point 3. So you can hear, if this is an ideal intercooler, the pressure at the state point 3 or P3, the pressure is again dropped. Sorry, the pressure, it will be the pressure, the pressure will remain constant. This P3 will be equal to P2. There will be no change in pressure. And here, this temperature at state point 3, what will be the temperature? T3. And this T3 should be equal to T1. Here you see, the T3 is equal to T1. T1, what is T1? Now T1 is ambient temperature. Okay. The rise in temperature recorded by fastest compressor here, T2. Okay. So this T2, by this intercooler arrangement, the heat is being released to cooling water, as a result of which it is again the state or the air temperature, compressed air temperature, is again reduced to T1. Then this air, compressed air, is sucked inside this second stage compressor. The second stage compressor volume is less in comparison to first stage compressor. Okay, so here it is, why this is less, I will tell you when drawing the indicator diagram for this. Okay, so then during the compression stroke, the air will be compressed and it will be delivered to the storage tank. Here it will be stored, the compressed air, it will be stored inside this tank. Then here, what will be the, this is the state point, what is the state point? The state point is 4, 1, 2, 3, this is the state point, thermodynamic state point 4. So what will be the pressure and temperature? Here the pressure is P4, okay, and necessarily P4 is equal to delivery pressure. P4 is equal to delivery pressure. What is delivery pressure? This delivery pressure is discharge pressure. Some call it discharge pressure also. And also you can tell this is the P storage tank. The storage tank pressure. At this pressure, it will be stored inside this tank. Okay. So here, again, there will be a little bit rise in temperature T4. But some aftercooler arrangement is there, so that's why the temperature will reduce. So this is the entire block diagram of a, here in the second stage compressor also there will be some cooling fin arrangement. So that during the compression process, the air will be cooled. So now you understood, this is the first stage compressor, this is the second stage compressor, and air is sucked inside. This is represented by state 1, the thermodynamic properties are written here. This is state 2 before intercooler, after intercooler this is state 3, the thermodynamic properties are there. And after the second stage compressor, the state 4, the thermodynamic properties are also being recorded here. Now as this is a very easy thing, nothing to bother, it's a very easy thing. So our main task, our main objective is to draw the indicator diagram for this. Our main objective is to draw the indicator diagram for this. So now I will draw the indicator diagram. So here, now I will draw the indicator diagram. Pay your full attention in understanding this. There was a heavy demand from you people. Whenever I take this online class, you people ask me to make this indicator diagram, make a YouTube video. That's why I am preparing it. Okay. So here, first I will make this along this abscis or y-axis. I will take this is the pressure. And along this x-axis, this will or this ordinate, that will be volume. As if you know, the indicator diagram is a function between pressure and volume. Or as I can tell you, P as a function of volume. Okay. So here the thing it is that how to draw this indicator diagram. The step-by-step approach or the hierarchy you understood, the same thing you will replicate, and the same thing you will follow whenever you draw the indicator diagram. So every now and then I always tell you, before drawing this indicator diagram, first you demarcate your area, first you put this boundary. So what should be the pressure limits? First I will go for these pressures. What should be the pressure limits? So here three pressure lines will be there. Okay. So what are the three pressure lines? The first one is your suction pressure. The air at which pressure will be sucked inside this first stage compressor, that will be your suction pressure. Okay, so put a dotted line. So here I can write, this is the suction pressure. Okay, here I can write, this is the suction pressure or PS. And this suction pressure is necessarily equal to ambient pressure PA. Ambient pressure is PA. So another pressure is your delivery or discharge line pressure. So this also a pressure line, you give a dotted line mark so that it will be understood. So this is your PD, delivery pressure. And in between this suction pressure and delivery pressure, you see here, this is the suction pressure P1 and T1. This delivery pressure is your P4 or T4. In between this suction and delivery pressure, there will be an intermediate pressure. What is that intermediate pressure? The intermediate pressure is the pressure of the intercooler, or the delivery pressure of first stage compressor is equal to the suction pressure of second stage compressor. As this is to the same line connected, or this is short, first stage compressor and second stage compressor. So obviously the delivery side of a first stage compressor is equal to the suction side of second stage compressor. And this pressure is called as your intermediate pressure. And this intermediate pressure is in between the ambient pressure and discharge pressure. So how I will represent it here inside this indicator diagram? Another pressure line I will draw, that will be intermediate pressure line. This is represented like this. So this will be intermediate pressure line PI. Okay. Now over. The pressure limit I have given, ambient pressure line, delivery pressure line, then intermediate pressure line, then along this volume. So what will be my boundary? The first thing, I will go for the clearance volume, because the piston will not collide against the cylinder head. If you not provide this clearance volume, ultimately this compressor or the cylinder piston arrangement is going to break. Okay, there will be a heavy damage, severe damage. So this is being represented as clearance volume, and this clearance volume or this point is called as this. This is the uppermost point. This point is otherwise called as your top dead center, and the piston has also got as a bottom dead center. Okay, so let this is the bottom dead center. So in between the stop dead center and bottom dead center, the piston reciprocates, and that displacement volume is called as, what is that called? That is called as your swept volume. VSWEP. VSWEP. And the clearance or the space or the volume between the top dead center and the piston head. This is the piston head here, okay, where this volume is zero. This is small volume. This is your, what is this? This is clearance volume. This is called as your clearance volume. Okay, so here I will again put a dotted line. So my indicator diagram region is within this area, is within this enclosed figure. Now it is very easy to draw the indicator diagram, or you follow the way I am drawing it, I am giving you procedures. Okay. So first thing I will make, this is for first stage, you can understand. This is for first stage, this region for second stage. Okay. This is region is for second stage. So whenever I am sucking the air, the induction stroke is going on, that induction stroke is being represented as here, I can say here. So from the stop dead center it will start, so it is starting like this. Now I am making it solid line or bold line as the induction process is going on. This is the induction process, very step by step approach I am moving, and very easy method I am going. This cannot be made easy more than that. So you try to understand this here. So this is your suction stroke. I will put the arrow mark at the last. So then after completing the suction stroke of the first stage compressor, there will be beginning of compression. When the piston will reach at the bottom dead center, it will come up and this compression process will carry out. So this compression process is given as one of the law I have given you, that this is the polytropic compression. This is polytropic compression is written as PP to the power N is equal to C. Polytropic compression, PP to the power N. There might be three compression processes: isothermal, polytropic and isentropic. Isentropic consumes highest amount of work. Isothermal compression consumes least amount of work. And the polytropic is the realistic one or the practical one, which consumes intermediate in between those two. So that's why I have given. Okay, so here this compression process carries out, and wherever it will meet this intersection or intermediate pressure line, this compression process continues. This ends here. Okay, and after the compression process or the required pressure in the first stage compressor or the desired pressure in the first stage compressor is made. Desired pressure means intermediate pressure is made. Once the intermediate pressure is attained inside the first stage compressor, the compressed air from the first stage compressor will be delivered into the second stage compressor. Okay. So this delivery process of this first stage compressor, I can show here the delivery process from this first stage compressor. It can come here. It will go like this. It will go like this. This is the delivery. Okay. The compressed air from the first stage compressor is being delivered inside the second stage compressor. It is being represented like this. Okay, so you can see here there will be, and up to which volume it can be compressed, that it can be discharged inside this first stage compressor, up to this clearance volume. There will be a little bit of compressed air that will be trapped inside this clearance volume, because the piston cannot go beyond this point. Okay, so this high pressure air which is trapped inside this clearance volume, it will push the piston backward. Okay, so this high pressure air, compressed air which is trapped, you cannot eject this out to this delivery tank. So this will eject, this will push this piston, and this expansion process is being represented like this. Wherever it will intercept, that will be there. Now you say, sir, you have started this suction here, and now it is expansion process is intersecting here. So how this will be possible? Actually, in this compressor, where there will be clearance volume, the compression does not begin from here. the compression, the suction process does not begin from here, does not begin from the top dead center. The suction begins from this point. Actually, the suction cannot commence as the piston reach up to this point, because here inside the compressed air will be there. So whenever the pressure inside the fastest compressor will just equal to the atmospheric pressure, at this point the piston is moving backward. It is going from top dead center to bottom dead center. Why the atmospheric pressure? Why the atmospheric air will not come inside this? Because the compressed air from this, it will expand. So it will not allow the atmospheric air to come inside this. But whenever it will reach the suction side pressure, the atmospheric pressure will rush inside this. So though this is the swept volume theoretically, but only the suction is taking place from this point up to this point. Okay, so this is the swept volume portion for actual suction, and that is why it is called as V effective swept volume. Mark this, effective swept volume. Okay, why this? Because the air, which is compressed air, which is trapped inside this clearance volume, that will not allow the atmospheric air to come inside this suction, just come inside this piston. But when this expansion process is going on, so the pressure inside the fastest compressor will come down, it is coming down. As the piston is moving backward, a point will come where this pressure inside this piston will be equal to atmospheric pressure. Then atmospheric side, then from atmospheric side, the air will come inside this. So at this point, actually the suction commences. That's why from this point up to the bottom dead center, this is called as effective swept volume. So mark the difference between swept volume and effective swept volume. This is important. Okay, so over. So now I can give some names. So this will be state point 1, and this where the suction ends, this will be state point 2, then this will be state point 3, and where this discharge ends, that will be state point, this will be state point 4. Okay, this will be state point 4. Now you can see another interesting thing here, another interesting thing comes here, you see. So this delivery of this fast stage compressor, it will be to whom? It will not in the storage tank. This delivery is inside this second stage compressor. So if I will put arrow mark for this suction side, this is going like this from top dead center to bottom dead center. Compression, this will be like this, then delivery. Then here you see another thing, the delivery of this fast stage compressor, it is delivering, but it is delivering to whom? You can see here the fast stage compressor, here it is state point 2, it is delivering, but it is delivering to whom? It is delivering to the second stage compressor. So delivery process of the fast stage compressor is nothing but the suction of the second stage compressor. So both delivery process line and suction pressure line of second stage compressor are same process. And how to represent this? So here you see, from this core, actually it is delivering, so simultaneously it is also the suction process. So this line will overlap. I can, for your understand, I can put it below here, but this is not below, it is overlapping. Okay, from this core here, it is again this suction at this second stage, because this intermediate is equal to your delivery of the first stage is equal to suction of the second stage. Okay, so here again it comes back. It comes back to up to which point? Now it will be represented something like here. Okay, you will say, sir, up to this point it will come, why the suction will come inside? That means from 4 to 5. Okay, sorry, this is from 4 to 5. So from 4 to 5, this is your suction of second stage. Why, sir, it is up to 5? Because why it cannot up to 3? Because here you see, due to this intercooler arrangement, I can say you this temperature, again it is reducing to T1. The temperature is, these state points here they will not same, because here 1, 2, 3, 4 states only here, because here we are coming with some more stages. So this intercooler, due to this intercooler arrangement, the temperature at this point here, there we cannot show the temperature. As this is an indicator diagram, I cannot show you the temperature. But the state point 5, the state point 5 means after this after this intercooler, okay, this T3 is equal to T5. So the temperature is being reduced. To which point it is reduced? It is reduced to ambient temperature. So as high pressure air, again it is at the ambient temperature, so the volume will be less. Why? Because you have, you people have seen this law, PV is equal to MRT. So temperature is directly proportional to volume. If temperature will fall, volume will fall. Okay, as temperature at this point after intercooler, we have arranged intercooler, we have incorporated intercooler for which purpose? To reduce the temperature. So if temperature will be reduced, the volume will reduce, and at that point I have told you the size of the second stage compressor will be less. Why? Because the compressed air is going into second stage compressor, but at atmospheric temperature. So obviously a smaller size of second stage compressor is required. So understood, this is the T5 will be less at the point V, volume V5 is less than V3. So you can see here, this is the another arrow some people put here. Okay, so this is the discharge of the first stage compressor, this is the suction of the second stage compressor. So discharge of the first stage compressor is being represented by the process 3 to 4, suction of the second stage compressor is being represented by state point 4 to 5. So after the suction ends, there will be compression process. So there will be compression process here, it will be like this. Okay. So whenever it will meet, or whenever it will attain the desired pressure, that is the delivery pressure, the compression will end. And that is the compression in the second stage process will come. And this compression process is being represented by the process again, that is PV to the power N is equal to constant. Then delivery from the second stage compressor will commence, and to whom it will delivered? From this second stage compressor, it will be delivered into the storage tank. So now it will be delivered into the storage tank. Okay, so this process, this is 5, so this is your set point 6. This will be the delivery portion up to 7. Now you can see here, this much of compressed air. Okay, this much of compressed air at this delivery pressure. What much of compressed air? That means that compressed air which is inside this clearance volume, it cannot be delivered to storage tank. Why it cannot be delivered? Because the piston cannot go beyond this point. So this compressed air, it will again come back. It will again expand. So this will again expand up to this point. Okay. Wherever it will meet, that will be 0.8. That means the same thing. So this suction, effective suction for the second stage is not from the 4 to 5, rather from 8 to 5. Like in this case, the suction, it is not from the top dead center to bottom dead center, that is from state point 1 to state point 2. Here also, the suction for second stage compressor is from state point 8 to state point 5. So this is a very realistic, very practical approach for the indicator diagram of a second stage compressor having clearance volume. But whenever we will go for mathematical derivations, directly we will not take this one into account. We will consider first the single stage compressor without clearance, then single stage compressor having clearance, then two stage compressor. Our syllabus only pointed up to this point, that is first stage compressor with without clearance volume and with clearance volume. So this is the procedure how the indicator diagram is done. You people read it, you people listen it carefully, and if people have got any doubt, you can personally ask me, or you can put it in your comment box. Thank you very much. Have a good day. Stay safe. Thank you.